Man, we're down here hanging out in Florida, escaping a brutally cold Minnesota winter, just trying to learn a thing or two about bass fishing down here in the Sunshine State. I've had two tournaments so far. Both I got a top 50 in. The FLW Tour event on Okeechobee, left there with a nice check, good points, and the Bassmaster Eastern, new format, lots of boats. I got a top 50 there, missed a check, but definitely good points to start off the season with towards the end of the year championship. It's spawning time in Florida. It's January, February, we got a good moon. We've been on a nice warming trend again down here after starting out with everything being pretty tough and cold. Two setups are sticking out to me of two things I've been using at both events to put fish in the boat in both practice and in the tournament itself. One thing I'm doing is I'm idling around and I'm using my Navionics map. I'm looking for sheltered areas that I think are gonna warm up quickly and offer bass a great place to spawn. When I get in those areas, I start out deep. I look around in the hydrilla, do a little target fishing, and I'm throwing an outcast tackle, heavy cover swim jig. This is the heavy cover version. It's great for using a braid. I'm using 50 pound Power Pro with a 20 to 25 pound fluorocarbon leader. I can make long casts with this. More importantly, when I get that bite, it's generally a bigger bite. I got enough backbone to really stick the fish and get them in the boat. And a lot of that comes from my Shimano X-Bride rod. I'm new to using this rod, this whole setup as a matter of fact. This is the new Shimano Frado K. This setup is awesome. I love it for anything that I'm reeling. I can make a long cast with it, with the braid. Again, I don't have that stretch factor. They hit it hard. I can stick them and I have the parabolicness and the setup to get the fish back and the winching power from the reel to get them back. This reel, again, this $179 reel, best reel I've ever used for under $300. The other setup I use once I come to a target, I visualize, look around, look for stuff that's manageable. Smaller targets that I think maybe a bass might be spawning in and or using to ambush prey. And what I do is I make a long cast with a BioSpawn Exo stick. This bait's awesome. It comes through the pads well. It doesn't rip up easy. The fat tail kind of lets me wiggle it around and actually freeze it to get through stuff. Produces a big bite. I'm using a G Loomis 7.5 heavy action GLX rod with a Mentanium reel. This is a high speed reel. Again, I'm using 50 pound Power Pro and a 25 pound fluorocarbon leader. And what I do, make a long cast, a quarter ounce Wu Tungsten. I can make a long cast with that and target those things. I just kind of drag the bait through there, using that GLX effectiveness to feel everything that's going on around there. And then you catch a lot of bucks, you know, you get to catch a lot of bucks, which play down here in Florida. And then every now and then you set the hook and it's a nice big one. Again, these have been the baits that I've been using down here while I've been down here, kind of the things that I've been tackling. Looking forward to the Harris chain, keep the momentum going, and hope to see you on the water. Stay warm if you're up in Minnesota. We'll be down here trying to catch big ones.